This is Bambu Lab's new SuperTack Build Plate, and it has a problem. It's too good. These prints don't come off easily. But more on that here in just a minute. Let's actually talk about this. This is the Bambu Lab brand new SuperTack Build Plate. This thing's adhesion is too good, quite honestly. It is so hard to get prints off of this. You actually do need this tool to pry the prints off. That's how good this adhesion is. They also do mention that if you are going to be using the scraper, that you are careful because the surface is quite soft, so you could potentially damage your build plate by using this incorrectly. Now, do note that this build plate is only suitable for PLA and PETG. Anything else is going to damage the surface on this thing. Bambu Lab does say, do not print TPU on this build plate. You will damage the surface. So, you know what? Don't do that. Bambu Lab does also recommend not to use any PLA silk filaments with this, as the adhesion will be too good and you're gonna rip off that super tacked right off that build plate. So you do have some things that you should not be printing with this. So do keep that in mind if you do pick this up. Now, some of the big selling points of this build plate is the fact that it will help eliminate adhesion issues. It's going to reduce warping when printing large objects. And they're even saying it's gonna save you on your electricity bill because it's a cool plate. Kinda, still kinda. Now, Bambu says that this is gonna save you money. Now, is that true? I guess there's only one way to find out. You know, let me know down in the comments below if I should explore that a little bit further and do a video about whether or not these will actually save you money. And maybe even compare it with the pricing versus the textured and maybe the original cool plate that they used to ship with. Let me know down in the comments below. So with the reduced electricity costs, what they're saying is that on this build plate, you only need to heat it up to 45 degrees Celsius for PLA, whereas with the textured build plate, you actually need to bring that up to 65 degrees Celsius. Check out this footage here I have on the screen right now. This was a little quick test just to do like an adhesion test to see how well it could hold while printing this test. Yeah, it does a pretty great job, doesn't it? So check this out. In order to get this off, this has been completely cooled off. I can't even pull this off. Okay, maybe I can. But that's just because it has a small surface area being held onto here. Some larger items that are on here are really hard to get off, and you do need to use your scraper. This is what I mean by it being too good. Printed these out, and they are seriously... Yeah, these don't come off very easily. What I found is that most of the time you are gonna need this, but one thing that I found really works is doing the bending on it, but like these just adhere so well. Got that one off, but like it ain't coming off. Like, yeah, the adhesion on this is phenomenal. Maybe a little bit too good. Now, over on Bambu Lab's website, this does come in the full size like this, and they do also have the A1 mini size. I have both, and I actually do like them, and I do like the surface finish that you get with these as well. But real quick, the price on this for the bigger size is $30, whereas the A1 mini comes in at $15. Now, one of the big downsides to using this build plate is removing the items off of it can actually cause damage to your prints. Like this one, for instance, this was supposed to be something that held some utensils, like some forks or spoons. And while I was trying to remove it, because it has a small gap right here, it snapped in half and broke. Now, that is something you do need to take into consideration when using this plate, is there's a good chance you could break whatever you're actually trying to pull off because the adhesion is just that good. The finish on this is actually really nice. You can still kind of see all the layer lines that are on the initial layer, but everything is nice and smooth. There's no texture to it. It's quite nice. Here's another good example of how the bottom layer looks. It's just, it's got a really nice finish to it. It's very smooth, like I said before. It's pleasing. I think these will actually work for some of the prints that I sell, and I think I want to use these more. So now the Bambu Lab Carbon X1 can detect the build plates, and there's actually a problem right now with the new SuperTack build plate. This thing is actually having a hard time reading the little QR code thing on the build plate, and it's actually throwing some errors. Right now, if you look on their website, they're actually saying you need to turn off the build plate detection and for this to actually work properly. So far, I found it to be hit or miss. I have ran into that in the past. So yeah, if you want to use this, you might actually have to turn that off. And you know what? I have one for my A1 Mini. I think I want more. I have 3 full-size printers here at home. And normally I run the textured plate on all of them, but with how good this is for adhesion, I kind of want to switch to this. But that would mean I would give up that textured bottom kind of look, and I'm not sure if I want to do that for everything. But for things that don't require that, like aesthetic, I might want to use this from now on. So I think with how well this actually adheres prints to the build plate, especially on that first layer, I think I'm really liking this build plate. The fact that you don't have to worry about warping as much on some of these prints that are like gonna take up the whole build plate is a really nice thing. And I think I wanna use this more. So let me know what you think about this build plate down in the comments below, because I am genuinely curious to see what everyone else thinks about this thing. This is Adam from the Rad Dad Print Lab. And I definitely think you should check out this video right here of the Wham Bam super cool build plate. I can't remember the name of it, but I'll put it right here. See ya. Hehehehe